Hello and welcome to the big picture. The overwhelming victory of the Aam Aadmi Party and the decimation of the two national level parties, the BJP and Congress, has opened up several possibilities. While BJP has something to talk about, having retained 32% of its vote share, almost the same it won in 2013, the Congress finds itself completely eliminated both in terms of seats and its vote share, coming down below 10%. What will this mean at the national level? Can the Aam Aadmi Party, which had made a bold venture in the last Lok Sabha elections, contesting almost 425 seats and losing deposit in almost all of them, spread out again? With its presence now only in Punjab, where it has 4 MPs, can the Aam Aadmi Party spread to other states too? What will be the impact on the BJP if Aam Aadmi Party starts spreading? Will the other non-Congress and non-BJP parties accept AAP as a pivot? There are many interesting questions which needs a debate. We will discuss all this today with Vinay Sahasrabuddhe, National Vice President of the BJP, Professor Pushottam Agarwal, Political Analyst and former Professor Venkatesh Ramakrishnan, Associate Editor of Frontline, Vipul Mudgal, Senior Journalist and Professor Anand Kumar of the Aam Aadmi Party. Welcome to all of you. Professor Anand Kumar, I'll come to you first.
Thank you.
You know, there has been enough discussions throughout the day about what happened in Delhi election. Now, if we have to look forward, is the Aam Aadmi Party can the Aam Aadmi Party think of spreading outside Delhi, apart from Punjab, of course?
Well, as you know, the present Vidhan Sabha election is in continuity with the Lok Sabha election, and in the Lok Sabha, as you rightly pointed out, Aam Aadmi Party had put up more candidates than even the two national parties, Congress and BJP. So the seed is already sown, and in last 8 months since Lok Sabha, we were engaged in Mission Vistar, which was to consolidate our supporters and our volunteers all over the country. Now we needed a new reputation, a new image, a new success story, because Lok Sabha was rather disastrous. We had only saved our securities in 30 constituencies and we could win only 4 seats.
Right.
And now Delhi success will energize us. And as you know, either you do a national level politics, otherwise you cannot confine yourself to a city state like Delhi. So both ways, political imperative as well as the ground realities, both are asking us for one more small step after Delhi election, and that is to get into organizing and mobilizing in the states on local issues as well as take energy from the Delhi success.
Okay, that's very important, and I'm glad you have been upfront about your ambitions. Mr. Vinay Sahasrabuddhe, does that sound a little ominous for the BJP, for the national parties, both the national parties and as far as you are concerned, as for the BJP? If Aam Aadmi Party, you know, as Professor Anand Kumar says, Mission Vistar, if they start this Mission Vistar, is that something ominous for the BJP?
Absolutely. Of that being anything ominous for BJP. In democracy, I think competition is something which is at the center. The central idea of democracy is about political competition, and therefore if one more party is there on the horizons, there is nothing wrong about it. We would welcome it. We had earlier also welcomed it. Point is that the challenges before our party are Herculean, and they need to organize their party as an organization in a loyal manner. I don't think there is any scope for winning the elections here onwards, because Delhi was relatively a small election. Of course, their success is really very remarkable, and one must congratulate the Aadmi Party, that is beyond doubt. But then, building a party organization, sustaining it, running it in a cohesive manner, and establishing as a genuine political initiative is a different ball game altogether, which is why I think the task of the is very challenging. One can only wish them a success, but then they are going to become a part of the game, the rules of which they desire to change. And unfortunately, they are not in a position to change those rules, which is why the task becomes all the more challenging.
What are these rules which they will not be able to change?
Several rules. I mean, see, once you are in a competitive politics, see, if there are certain compromises that keep happening in politics, it is because of also makes you enter into a compromising mode in a competitive spirit. One party compromises, the other party also desires to compromise. That is how it happens. Any student of political parties realizes, which is why, if they are in a game in which there is some kind of partisanship, there is some kind of competition practically every other day, and they are wanting to sing a different tune, which is very different, which is very difficult being in the same bandwagon, they have now become a political party. Now, to become a political party, just like several other, and there are 1300 odd political parties in India, and even then to claim that we are going to embark upon a new style of politics is really very hard. I wish them every luck, but nonetheless, this task is very difficult, and it will require every kind of courage, at the same time every kind of capacity to really take it to its logical end.
Okay, that's very interesting. I'll come to you. Before I come to my studio guest, I think I'll get Professor Anand Kumar. Professor Anand Kumar, would you like to respond to that?
Well, Professor Sasubuddhe has his own experiences and he has seen how a party with idealism of Gandhian socialism drifted away so far. And now it is beyond recognition because it's also engaged with some kind of liberalization, privatization, and globalization of crony capitalist variety. So I take his caution with due respect, but I must say that Aam Aadmi Party is creating certain rules for itself, where crossing those rules will be self-destructive. And one example was putting all the money which is coming to us on a public website. Similarly, the four C's for our candidates: communalism, crime, corruption, and characterlessness. These barriers will make us protected from the compromises which are imperative of parliamentary democracy in India today.
Okay.
And thirdly,
okay,
we are also going to take the opportunity of any success to go for alternative political culture, and I hope that the other parties will help us in reforming the election rules.
Okay, I mean, very brave words. As on date, they were very brave words, though welcome. Professor Agarwal, brave words?
Yeah, of course, brave words, and I hope honest words also.
Yes.
Professor Anand Kumar is right that, and I look at this unprecedented massive mandate in favor of AAP, not as a mandate only for Aam Aadmi Party or only for Arvind Kejriwal. It is actually a mandate for a different kind of politics. And this different kind of politics, I am afraid that BJP and in fact also the Congress, they are not even able to comprehend the nature of that different kind of politics. It's a very different kind of politics. Things are transparent. I mean, just imagine. People think that Aam Aadmi Party has won only because of the work it did in last 1 month, immediately after the last elections, last Lok Sabha elections. I mean, this is unprecedented that a political party and its face, that is Arvind Kejriwal, goes around organizing sorry sabhas, apologizing to the people. I do not remember any political party apologizing for any kind of its political acts. Then here is a person who declares support unilaterally, and the party refuses to take that support. Right. The party organizes daily dialogues with women, with students, with this, with that. This is the newness of Aam Aadmi Party. Not this media or money and all that. This newness, real interaction with people, real input from people, and capacity and willingness to learn from people. I think these are the real achievements of this election, and this mandate is for the new kind of politics. And if Aam Aadmi Party continues with this new kind of politics,
That so you are saying that already
they
have already started a new kind of politics.
Of
not
have.
That as Mr. Sasrabuddin thinks that, you know, no. They are embarking on something new.
They have already started, and this massive mandate, 67 out of 70, is actually a mandate for that new kind of politics.
Okay, Vipul.
Second
thing is, you know, we are talking about Mission Vistar, as Professor Anand Kumar calls it.
You see, the beginning has been made of a new politics. Political party reforms is something that a lot of people have been talking about. Even Bharatiya Janata Party in its own way has been talking about. Country has discussed at various levels the funding models of political parties. Can there be a state funding of political parties, etc., etc.? But there are some changes which are absolutely irreversible. And one of them is the transparency of political parties' funding of elections. Then, Aam Aadmi Party, by all means, I am not saying that they don't have to answer anything. They may have a lot to answer. But, you know, it's very interesting that a party which has spent 2,500 crores is asking a party which has spent 2 crores to explain everything. But the fact is that if you have the courage to put everything you are getting from every source on a website, even if it comes at the cost of making yourself vulnerable, I think it's the beginning of a very interesting new politics.
Absolutely. You know, Professor Anand Kumar said that we had made mistakes, and he said, very interestingly, he said that actually putting the, you know, all the donations which they get on the website, but I hope they will continue to do it and they will not change that.
I think he was describing that as a mistake. He was talking of other mistakes.
You will continue to be as transparent as you have been, which is a good thing. Venkatesh, well, looking at Aam Aadmi Party now, as Professor Anand Kumar says, Mission Vistar, how far it will be successful? Where do you think they will be able to make a dent in the, say, in the next 6 months, 1 year?
No, organizationally, I think it is what Aam Aadmi Party has shown is something unprecedented, as all other panelists have said. But having said that, I think the kind of approach that they have and the kind of language, political language that they are using, that essentially appeals to an urban constituency at this point of time.
It's a new political language.
It's a new political language, a political language which appeals to an urban constituency at this point of time. In a sense, what I'm saying is, when I say urban constituency, I don't mean the urban voter in the sense, you know, the elite voter or the middle class voter. But I'm saying a constituency where, you know, where you can actually spread this message using various methods and various forms. So having this in mind, I think, you know, the first major gains of the Aam Aadmi Party in its Mission Vistar mode, apart from Delhi, would be, say, metropolitan cities like Bangalore or Bombay, where they already have a significant presence, and where this kind of politics has a lot of takers, especially among the youth.
Youth and also the underclass, the dispossessed.
Yeah, where the message can be reached to them. But I do not know whether they will be able to replicate the same kind of you know, results or same kind of penetration in a state like Uttar Pradesh, which is very vast, where already you have, you know, identity politics of various kinds of holding, a place like Bihar. So these places, I do not know whether with this, the current organizational mode that they have, whether they will be able to penetrate.
Very interesting. Professor Anand Kumar, would you like to respond to that? The next elections in this country is going to be held in...
Yes, that's a very important point. Actually, our Mission Vistar is started soon after June, assessment of our Lok Sabha performance. And we found so far that states where the politics is bipolar between Congress and BJP, we have much better reception across the classes and regions and rural-urban divide. And they are Punjab, where we have already won 4 seats in Lok Sabha, Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh. Right. And then I am in charge of Bihar and Uttarakhand, and I must report that we have gone practically to every district of Uttarakhand to Bihar, and from Tibet border to Nepal border. You see the unevenness of internal politics. At the same time, you see a common quest for going beyond politics of identity to politics of survival. And this is where, if we do our homework, we go for front organizations, create forum for women, space for students and youth, kisans, ex-servicemen, traders, lawyers and doctors, and of course the writers and cultural activists, there is a whole lot of space available around RTI activism.
Right.
I have to report to all the panelists that there is a new kind of political activism. It's called RTI activists. They need shelter, they need backup, they need interconnectivity. And this is where Aam Aadmi Party will have a new approach and of course a new constituency.
So you think that even in a state like Bihar, you can still make an impact despite all the disadvantages, apparent disadvantages which you seem to have?
No, as it happened in Delhi, Delhi was a different cup of tea for us during Lok Sabha. There was a lot of identity politics, there was mixing up of various political traditions, right from the left to Bollywood stars, and we lost it. But then we again got back to our elementary task,
okay,
of connecting with people, organizing them, mobilizing them. I have covered Bihar, and I must report that Bihar has some surprises in the store, provided Aam Aadmi Party in Delhi does good, exemplary work as party in power.
Okay. Mr. Sasrabudde, how would you respond to that? You know, would you, how are the national parties or the traditional parties which have been operating for decades now going to, how are you people going to respond to this kind of a new political EBM which the Aam Aadmi Party has brought into politics?
Well, I think there is nothing like a new political idiom, but yes, of course, I mean, the verdict of the Delhi election makes everybody of us to sit up and think about. But one thing is certain, that people have become restive. They want results. Here onwards, the politics and both governance is going to be much more result-oriented. I mean, from the people's point of view, people are going to expect some kind of a transformation in the quality of life, their day-to-day life. If that we are able to achieve, then only there is some scope for survival. Now, these people, the Aam Aadmi Party, they will be put to test on the governance count. What can they deliver? And in the delivery process, you also have to engage with the people, you have to educate the people. I don't know whether they really will be able to educate the people on the one hand, on the other hand, also take the bureaucracy, take the official dumb on their side, take them on board, and make the entire governance apparatus more kind of a delivering or result oriented apparatus. Unless and until they are able to do that, because not everything could be delivered in such a short span, and he has been rightly saying that if at all the Aam Aadmi Party delivers in Delhi as per the expectations, then certainly in Bihar he is expecting some good things, and every good luck for the Aam Aadmi Party. But delivery is not something as easy as winning the election. Winning election is one thing. I certainly don't want to undermine the importance of their winning election. I congratulate them. But at the same time, delivering on the governance count is a different ball game, and they will have to acquire fresh and new skills to deliver on the count of governance.
Mr. Sasrabudde, when you talk of governance, when you talk of delivery, do you think that, you know, there was something lacking because of which your party suffered in Delhi? Because when you talk of delivery and governance, I'm sure, you know, people of Delhi who live in Delhi, who get affected by what the central government does, you think that has been to certain extent responsible for the kind of defeat which your party has faced in Delhi?
Well, yes and no, because on certain counts, policy decisions have already happened, certain reforms are already in the pipeline, but the trickle-down effect is going to take some more time. By the time these reforms reach to the people and they make some changes, some positive transformations in their day-to-day life, I think it is going to take time. But no, because on certain issues we already have performed. but we perhaps have failed in taking those transformations right up to the people. Say, for example, I am taking the example of the All India Institute of Medical Sciences in Delhi, where a new telephone-based registration system has been made operational by Dr. Harshavardhan when he was the health minister. And that has eased the registration at the hospital quite a lot. People are now having a sigh of relief. But this particular, it's a small reform, I understand. It's a small administrative step.
Okay.
But then, had we kind of built upon that, had we kind of taken it effectively right up to the people, that would have perhaps had a different kind of impact.
Maybe,
we failed on that count, and which is why there is much more for us to introspect about.
Maybe if you had got Harshvardhan to continue as health minister, he would have been able to carry that message forward. Professor Agrawal?
No, I was just recalling that it is exactly the same language which was being spoken by Congress spokespersons after the last Lok Sabha elections. That we did wonderful job, but we failed to communicate. The problem, however, is that, for example, let us talk of health. Okay, something was done in All India Institute of Medical Sciences. But then the Sanjeev Chaturvedi case also happened in All India Institute of Medical Sciences. And moreover,
And
massive cut in health expenditure.
Right.
Tremendous increase in the prices of life-saving drugs. The point which I wanted to make,
talking of Aam Aadmi Party's expansion.
I am coming to that.
Yes.
In fact, what has happened in Delhi, a large chunk of Congress-oriented votes has shifted to Aam Aadmi Party.
That is exactly
this is extremely important.
Yes.
And if, in fact, the rise of Aam Aadmi Party is a sure shot warning bell to Congress,
right,
more so than the BJP.
Right.
If Aam Aadmi Party continues with good work in Delhi, if it continues to focus on organizations and most importantly on the interactive dialogue with people, then I think the hopes and expectations of Professor Anand Kumar are not very unrealistic.
Unrealistic. Vipul, you know, first, the major impact has been on the Congress. How far it will impact Congress in other states where the Aam Aadmi Party is going to spread?
I think both Congress and BJP, I think BJP and Congress haven't understood what has happened. Now I hear, you know, very learned Professor Sahasrabuddha talking about how would you educate the public. I think it's the public which is educating the political parties, and political parties are refusing to take the hint from the public. Public is very clearly saying that you political parties need to change. And I think that change we are not seeing anywhere. You know, for instance, internal democracy in political parties. Now, we see a high command culture, and we bought into it completely when Bharatiya Janata Party said that Congress party has this high command culture, and this high command culture is undercutting all party workers, and it's not letting democracy breathe within the party, etc., etc. Now, we see that you bring an outsider and you inform the really old leadership of the party in half an hour.
Same kind of culture of the Congress is visible here. Venkatesh?
Absolutely. I think this is what organizationally what Aam Aadmi Party has achieved is that you know that.
No, would you agree with Anand Kumar about his assessment that, you know, they'll be able to spread across their, this Mission Vistar is actually something which can give us some surprises in, say, a state like Bihar?
Yeah, I think the approach that they've adopted, I mean, especially in terms of connecting with people and understanding the needs and aspirations of the people, I think that is certainly good. And the organizational mechanism which they have evolved to kind of advance this is also very good. But I still have this doubt. See, I had spoken to Arvind Kejriwal just a few days before he launched the party. I had asked him, see, there are very major core issues like land reforms. There are issues like, you know, globalization. On all these issues, there is no stated position that the Aam Aadmi Party seems to have. I think, you know, while the organizational maneuvers and the methodology that they have adopted, the kind of interactive politics that they have developed with the people, all that is, you know, path-breaking, I think they also need to evolve positions on all these issues.
Exactly. Professor Anand Kumar, how do you respond to that? You know, one of the things, but in what Venkatesh was mentioning, land reforms and things like that, but it's very interesting that we are told that this whole ordinance on land acquisition was actually one of the major issues in the Delhi elections. And the doubts expressed by Venkatesh about you not having positions on major issues of, you know, economic matters.
That's a very good important point because in the last 2 years, we have taken questions which are certainly not allowing anybody to have any doubt about the direction which we are taking, though small steps. For example, liberalization, globalization, privatization. We have a clear position that we are not in support of foreign direct investment in retail trade. Second, we are not supporting crony capitalism, no matter what. We have asked for cases against crony capitalists of the country, the top ones. Similarly, in case of land-related issues, we are openly and clearly against the ordinance issued by Sri Narendra Modi government. So we go step by step, issue by issue, and so far our record is such that in the media we are being presented as left of the center political formation in the making. We are not very comfortable with that kind of a leveling, but at the same time, on the economic front, as you know, it is certainly a party which is perceived as pro-poor, and it has converted identity politics into class politics in Delhi elections.
Okay, sir.
You must give us a little credit, though it is not so outstanding.
Okay, sir. We are giving you credit. Nobody can take the credit away from when we see this kind of a verdict coming in your favor. No, who can take the credit away from you? But anyway, thanks for clarifying some of the issues. We completely ran out of time. The fact of the matter is that Aam Aadmi Party is now sailing very high. We'll have to wait and watch whether they'll be able to expand beyond Delhi and how effectively they'll be able to expand. Thanks to all my guests. Professor Anand Kumar, Vinay Sahasrabuddha, Venkatesh Ramakrishnan, Professor Agarwal and Vipul Mudgal, please keep watching. We'll come back with another vision, big picture, same time tomorrow.